comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Laid off as it caught the inside corner. Just a bit jumpy that time. Swung on and missed.
Beautifully thrown splitter right there. High 80s, down in the zone. Looks like a fastball coming in, and then it just drops off the table. You can get a lot of swinging strikes with that.
Still no balls and two strikes. Here it comes. Now that ball is hit well, deep down the left field line, headed toward the foul pole. And this will wind up being nothing more than a long foul ball, and it'll hold the count at 0-2. Now Kemp swings and sends a high fly ball with good carry out to deep left field. And as Dodger fans have heard for years, she is out of here. A solo shot here to left, and it's now a one-run ball game. Ball's jumping in this one. That's the fourth to leave the yard so far.
Matty V, this is just one of those days where the ball seems to be flying, D-Row. The hitter's on point. The pitchers aren't making very good pitches.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It's all about executing pitches, and they're not doing it today. They're leaving a lot of balls over the heart of the plate, and this offense, both offenses, are taking advantage.
Yasiel Puig will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 66.
Swing and a ball line hard towards short, but unfortunately right at the shortstop for the second out. So that'll bring in the National League rookie home run record holder, Cody Bellinger. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. He's set. Here it comes. Hit sharply but foul down the right side. With this one almost in books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-World, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head into their final set of swings. So just the one hit in the inning, but it's a home run that pushes him out in front. On to the bottom of inning number 9. 4-5 out in front, 3-2. Pedro Baez is the man called on to close this.
Number 52, Pedro Baez.
First delivery to him on the way, and he fouls this one off. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
It's becoming more and more common in today's game to see relievers like this that can run it up there close to 100 miles per hour, but it's so fun to watch it. He blew it right by him there.
And I believe your tying run's going to be in scoring position right away as this is down for extra bases.
That's the perfect answer after you've given up the lead in the previous inning. Put the tying run
on.
Kenley Jansen takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Number 74, Kenley Jansen.
set and the pitch. And he pops up the bunt attempt. Turner is there to make the catch, and that's a big out number one. Third.
Now batting, third baseman, Mike Moustakas.
Open stance by Moustakas, and now the pitch. There's a strike. Sharp slider that time, just missed inside. Aguilar leads off second with one gone in the inning. One and two. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Stepping in now, Manny Pena. As with two away, he'll swing and miss at the first pitch. It's 0-1. They'll go to work on getting that tying run home from second. Good pitch as this is swung on and missed, and now they're down to perhaps their final strike of the evening. The Brewers down to their final strike. Struck him out, so he'll strand the possible tying run at second, and a great job of working out of trouble as this ball game is over.
Well, that's just a great job of battling on the road. They fought all the way to the end, took the lead in the top of the ninth, and secured the W in the bottom half. That's a great team win.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. It was mostly pitching and defense in this one, but the man you see here made some noise with the bat, and as a result, he's our top player of the game.
Well, he blasted a couple of balls over the wall in this one, really put the guys on his back and carried him to the victory.
Three to two, the finish in tonight's game. Los Angeles came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Ryan Matson pitches well enough to get the W. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa and the lefty Dan Plesac and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Dodgers. Three runs. Five hits, no errors. They left four men on base.
Robinson.
Just days before the 40-round MLB draft, some lesser-known prospects get one last chance to make an impression at Bowman Scout Day. His name having finally been called, an anxious prospect steps up for his turn to put his plate skills on display. Never has this player had the chance to command the attention of so many big league buyers. He looks to make his case for draft consideration. Most of today's Scout Day participants are not considered blue chip prospects, but they all have blue chip aspirations. A player looks to follow up his efforts at the plate with a demonstration of solid defensive fundamentals. At the major league level, the defensive standard is near perfection. This prospect looks to deliver as clean a performance as he can. Thank you. Done for the day and heading back to the locker room, this player is met by one of the scouts in attendance. While preparing for the first of two games at the Topps Amateur Showcase, a prospect is approached by a representative of the MLB Scouting Bureau.
MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Today we get the ball rolling with an intriguing matchup on day one. Prospects from the Central region. Stepping up to the plate, Cam Rivera, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. On the ground out to second, Robinson. Throw in time at first for out number two. Settling in now, Mark Beyer. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Mark Beyer.
The 1-2. Play, but it's swung on and grounded to second. Robinson. And the throw just does beat him at the bag, so the side is retired. Nothing across here this half of the inning. On now to the bottom of the second, and we are tied nothing. Stepping into the box, Jackie Robinson.
Leading off for the West prospect, second baseman, Jackie Robinson.
Here comes the first pitch. Line toward center field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So that puts the leadoff man aboard to get the inning underway.
Yeah, and every scout at this showcase appreciates a hitter that can take the ball right back up the middle. And it shows he's got a controlled swing and great timing, which is really what you want from your hitters.
So stepping in, Jorge Ozuna.
Batting seventh, left fielder, Jorge Ozuna.
He's running, and he'll step off. But he's safe at first as he gets back in time. On the move again from first. Got him swinging to throw. In time as he just gets the tag down.
Yeah, he was trying to show these scouts that he has some big-time speed and that he could do some damage on the Major League base pass, but it backfired on him. Hey, I applaud the aggressiveness, and so did the scouts, but it would have looked a whole lot better if he had slid in safely. He was trying to show these scouts that he has the speed.
Digging in, Jackie Robinson. He reached on a single in his first try.
Robinson.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Hard hit ball to second.
There's one. On to first, and they get the double play.
Man, just when he was trying to get something going, he rolls over the top of one and rolls right into a double play. Boy, that is a momentum killer like nothing else. He busted his butt down the first, but it just wasn't meant to be. That was not the at-bat he envisioned having with scouts watching.
Digging in for his second at-bat, Mark Beyer. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. Rivera aboard here at first with nobody out. Ground to second base. This could be two. In. One there. On to first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw. So digging in now, Jackie Robinson, a hit in two tries so far.
Jackie Robinson.
Here's the first pitch to him. Takes this the other way to right, and that's in there. Base hit. Ritter blows through the stop sign, headed for home. And he's safe at the plate, as it's now a one-run ball game. Into the box now, Jorge Ozuna, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. And the runner's breaking for third. Shoots this one over to first. And that's through into right field for a base hit. Tag not in time. And this ball game is tied here in the seventh. Now at the plate, Keith Dietz, 0-for-2 with a sacrifice thus far.
Designated hitter.
The 0-1 delivery. Hard on the ground is short. A diving try, but it's through into the outfield. Throw will hold him at second, but the go-ahead run's in scoring position now. Coming to the plate now, Jackie Robinson. They'll go to work on getting that tying run home from second. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Run it out, run it out.
Oh, he makes the stop. What a play.
Hey, on the bright side, he does move the runner over, which in a regular game is what a manager would want for him. But in a showcase, this is a different animal, and he knows it. He wants to drive the ball, get base hits, and drive in runs, which he was unable to do.
Fans on their feet in a one-run ball game in the last of the ninth. And he lays off for ball one. And this is swung on and missed. So with that, they find themselves down to their final strike here this afternoon. Into the corner and slicing foul. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. And he struck him out, and the ball game is over as they get the possible tying run over to third, but can't get him across.
Well, this one had its moments of drama and excitement. In the end, these guys came away with a victory, and look on to the next one.
A one-run finish, 4-3, the final tally today. The Central came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Greg Riggs gets the W on the mound, so that'll just about do it for us this afternoon. Thanks to Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. To find out more, head over to theshownation.com.
For the Central, 4 runs on 8 hits. No errors. They left 9 runners on base. For the home team, 3 runs on 9 hits. No errors. They left 8 men on base. Time of the ballgame, 3 hours and 8 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.